गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज हंसा योर साइंस टीचर एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन विच इज रिलेटेड विद द सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम्स इनसाइड द बॉडी एंड इट इन्वॉल्व इट कंसिस्ट द सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम कंसिस्ट द डिफरेंट पार्ट थ्रू विच द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन विल टेक प्लेस. And the which consists first is heart, which is a pumping organ. First part, the first component, first part of the transportation or the circulatory system is heart, which is a pumping organ, means pump the substance. What the substance? Pump the blood. It work as a pump. Heart work as a pump, which pump the blood. Inside the body. Second is arteries and vein. Arteries and vein are the blood vessels, means arteries and veins through which the blood is passed, means passes of blood. It means they carry the blood. Blood flow through the arteries or through the veins. These are the blood vessels. The second one is the circulatory system is arteries and vein. And third one is blood and lymph. These are the medium, circulatory mediums, means is a fluid medium. These are the component of the circulatory system, and the first one we will discuss is heart. Heart is a pumping organs. It act as a pump, which is as small as our fist. It is very soft and jelly-like structure, which help to pump the blood at a given pressure. Heart is a pumping muscular organ which as big as our fist, and it carry both blood, carry both carbon dioxide and water, carbon dioxide and oxygen to be through the blood, means oxygen or carbon dioxide which transfer inside our body with the help of blood. And how the heart pump the blood and the circulatory system, means function of heart. How does the heart work? Heart is the muscular organ or a pumping organ which help to push the blood at a high pressure or a low pressure. Means it exert the pressure on the wall of the blood vessels. That is the blood pressure. Heart mainly consists in human being, it consists four chamber. Two chamber on right side and two chamber on left side. And the right side chamber and left side chamber are separated to each other. They never mix with each other. Right side has two part, atrium and ventricle. Left side also has two part, atrium and ventricle. That means the fourth chamber of a heart name first is right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium, left ventricle. These are the four chamber, and the right part, right atrium, right ventricle, these are the right part, and left ventricle, left atrium, this is the left part, and these right and left never mix with each other. Why they never mix each other? To carry the pure blood inside the body, to get more and more energy, to get the oxygenated blood inside the body, not to receive any type of impure blood inside the body. Therefore, the separation between right and left is necessary. As you know that the two part, right side had two part and left side had two part. Left atrium, left ventricle, right atrium, right ventricle. First of all, left part of the heart, means right, left atrium, left ventricle, always carry or have the pure blood, oxygenated blood, whereas right part of the heart, mean right atrium, right ventricle, always carry, always have, always pass only the deoxygenated blood. left always receive, left always contain pure blood, right always contain impure blood. And the blood is received to the heart from any part, either from lungs or from all part of the body. Receive, only vein receive the blood, either from lungs or from part of the body. Vein is the blood vessels which receive the blood either from lungs or from all part of the body. Whereas when the heart allowed to pass the blood, or the blood is away from heart, means carry, the blood is carried either to the heart, either to the lungs or to the part of the body, that is done by the arteries. Means veins is the receiver of blood and arteries is the dispatch, supply of blood. Vein receive the blood from part of the body or from lungs, but arteries always transfer the blood from heart to either all part of the body or to the lungs. If the blood goes to the heart or goes to the lungs from heart, if the blood goes to lungs from heart, that means the blood has to be purified. And when the blood transfer or goes from lungs to heart, that means the pure blood is received by the heart from the lungs. It means lungs is used to purify the blood. Means deoxygenated blood change into oxygenated blood. Blood goes to lungs only for the purification, because you know it very well, it contains alveoli, where the exchange of gas will take place, means receiving oxygen and releasing carbon dioxide. Therefore, when the blood goes to lungs only for the purification. And now, how does it the heart is work? First, lungs. In lungs, the blood is to be purified, and the purified blood from lungs reach to the heart. And which part of the heart is received the oxygenated blood? It means lungs, blood from lungs to heart, and which part of the heart will receive, and that will be received by the receiver blood vessel, which one is vein, which vein is pulmonary vein. Pulmonary veins is the vein or the blood vessels which receive the pure blood from lungs, and that goes to the heart of the left part. It means the blood is reached to the left atrium. When this left atrium will relax and receive the blood from the lungs through the pulmonary veins. Pulmonary veins receive the oxygenated blood from lungs and transfer to the left atrium when it will relax. And when the left atrium is completely filled, it will contract. And then the blood is from left atrium transferred to the left ventricle. And then left ventricle, when completely filled, and then it exert pressure, and the blood from left ventricle transferred to all part of the body or the body organ through the blood vessels, which is known as largest arteries. And this largest arteries is aorta, A-O-R-T-A. Aorta is the largest arteries which carry the pure blood from heart to all part of the body which need high pressure. Therefore, the wall of this arteries is thick as compared to vein, because vein need not require any much pressure as compared to arteries. Arteries require thick wall because it has to exert the pressure, exert the blood with a high pressure. Vein have less pressure of blood
therefore it required valve to prevent the backflow of water blood to prevent the backflow of blood therefore vein required valve and artery does not require any type of valve. So valve, the function is to prevent the backflow of blood. And now the oxygenated blood from the left ventricle through the aorta reach to the all part of the body, and then it will pass to each and every part, every cell or the tissue which need oxygen, and then supply and carry the impure substance throw them away and enter to the again heart. And now the right part of the heart will receive the blood, and that blood will deoxygenated blood, impure blood. It means right part always receive the impure blood from all part of the body is the right atrium. And the right atrium receive the impure blood from all part of the body through a veins, and that is known as vena cava. It means vena cava is the largest vein which receive the blood from all part of the body and transfer to the right atrium. When right atrium become relaxed and it receive the blood from all part of the body through vena cava, and when it completely filled, it compressed, and the blood is passed through the left right ventricle, from right atrium to right ventricle, and the right ventricle receive the blood from the right atrium. When the right ventricle is completely filled, then it passed to the lungs for the purification. And this blood from right ventricle to the lungs carried by the arteries, and this is known as pulmonary arteries. Pulmonary arteries carry the impure blood from left, from right ventricle to the lungs for the purification of blood. Pulmonary arteries carry the impure blood to the lungs for purification, whereas pulmonary vein carry the pure blood from lungs to heart. Vena cava is the largest vein which receive the impure blood from all part of the body, whereas largest arteries is aorta, which supply the blood from heart to all part of the body. In this way, the blood will pass through the heart to complete one cycle. It means blood has to pass in heart two times to complete one circulation. It is known as double circulation. And now keep it in mind, lungs is the part of the circulatory system which is used to purify the blood. It means the blood when goes to the lungs only for the purification, and thus the blood from the lungs reach to the left atrium. Left part always receive the oxygenated blood through the pulmonary veins. It means left atrium receive the pure blood from the lungs through the pulmonary veins and is oxygenated blood, and when it will relax, it will goes to the left ventricle, the pure blood in the left ventricle, and from the left ventricle is passed to the body organ where the oxygen is required through the main arteries, largest arteries which carry the oxygenated blood, which is aorta. And this oxygenated blood passed by the aorta to all part of the body, and then the blood is passed, moved to all part of the body. The blood carry the impure substance with them, and this is deoxygenated blood. And from the body organ, the deoxygenated blood goes or transfer to the right part, means right atrium. Right atrium receive the impure blood or deoxygenated blood from body part with the help of main vein, largest vein, which is known as vena cava. Vena cava is the largest vein or the main vein which receive the impure blood from all part of the body, and that will transfer to the right atrium, right part of the heart, always receive the impure blood, and this impure blood from right atrium goes to the left right ventricle, and thus right ventricle, when it contract, and the blood which is impure or deoxygenated transferred to the lungs for the purification through the pulmonary arteries, and the pulmonary arteries which carry the impure blood to the lungs for the purification. It means the blood pass the heart two times, first on the left side and second is right side. It means it complete one cycle. When it pass the heart, blood will pass the heart two times. Therefore, it is known as blood circulation. Double circulation. Double circulation. Blood travels twice, TWICE, through the heart to complete one cycle. It means blood has to pass twice, two times inside the heart to complete one cycle. This is the function of heart. And this, after this, there are the two type of circulation. First is pulmonary circulation, second is systemic circulation. Pulmonary circulation means only when there will be link or involvement of the organ which is known as lungs. It means either the blood will goes to lungs for purification, or either supply the pure blood. It means when the blood move from heart to lungs, why the blood move from heart to lungs? Blood move from heart to lungs only for the purification. It means when lungs receive the blood from the heart or blood back to the heart. It means first heart to lungs and back to it. This is pulmonary circulation. The blood if pass from heart to lungs and then reverse or back to the heart, means from lungs to heart. Heart through lungs means through which pulmonary arteries for purification, and then the pure blood or oxygenated from bulk blood from lungs to heart, which received by the pulmonary veins. It means this is known as pulmonary circulation. Pulmonary circulation involves the blood vessels, both will be pulmonary, whether it is pulmonary vein or pulmonary arteries. Pulmonary circulation of blood, that the when the blood is passed from heart to lungs for purification and then back to the heart, the pure blood from lungs to heart is known as pulmonary circulation. Second is systemic circulation. When the blood from heart to all part of the body and then from all part of the body to the heart. It means when the blood is passed from heart to all part of the body and again back to heart is known as systemic circulation. Means when blood is passed from heart to all part of the body, it means that carry the pure blood, and the blood received by the heart, which is impure blood. It means when heart either release the blood or push the blood or receive the blood, that is the systemic circulation. If the lungs receive the blood or supply the blood, that means pulmonary circulation. There are two types of circulation, pulmonary circulation and systemic circulation. The separation of right side and left side of the heart is useful to keep the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood mixing. Means the right part of the heart and left part of the heart to be separate to prevent the intermixing of pure and impure blood. Why we need to prevent the mixing of pure and impure blood? Because it allows the efficient supply of oxygen to the body. If the right part and left part is separated, that means blood carry the more and more oxygen, which supply to the part of the body and which has more energy. Means supply more energy, give more energy to the organism. when the prevention of pure and impure blood will take place. Second, this oxygenated blood is useful for those animals which require more energy to maintain their body temperature. It means this prevention or the separation of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood is useful for those organisms, those animals which need more energy to maintain their body temperature, because they do not depend on other factors to the environment. They depend only the blood, and that blood should be pure, oxygenated, and these oxygenated blood help to maintain the temperature of the body and also maintain the pH of the body. And second, the animal who do not depend upon these oxygenated blood, it means they maintain their body temperature from the environmental. As the temperature of the environment will change, they adapt their body temperature itself. It means this oxygenated blood only required for the organism which maintain their body temperature, like birds and animals. And those who do not require oxygenated blood, they maintain their body temperature from the environment, like amphibians and some reptile which maintain their body temperature from the environment. It means they have three chamber of heart. It means the organism which maintain their body temperature with the help of oxygenated blood, they have the four chamber of heart. And the other one is three chamber, and fish has only two chamber of heart. And you know how the fish get the oxygen from the water. It means the oxygen, when the water received through the mouth, fish receive the water through the mouth with a high pressure and exert to the gills. It means gill receive the oxygen from the water, and that will be circulate inside the fish, and that complete one cycle. In one cycle, blood circulate only one time through in the heart in fish, and there will be fish and in amphibian, in there will be possibilities of mixing. There is a mixing of the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood, because they do not depend upon the oxygen. They maintain their body temperature from the outside, and this way there will be a complete function of heart. How does it work, and what is the blood, and what is the function of blood?